Hey, brothers and sisters, anybody hoping for Harpazo? Anybody not know what the number 726 is? 726, Harpazo, caught up. Yeah, this is my old phone that I use to talk on, and it's got like a pink screen. So I've always seen things through rosy-colored glasses, if you could say. But I was pretty surprised when this video came up. And it had 726 views. 1 Thessalonians 4. There'll be a trumpet call of God. Not a trumpet here on earth, even though it could happen at Feast of Trumpets. And the voice of an archangel. And Jesus will come down on a cloud. And the dead in Christ will be caught up. And then we who remain alive and remain, who are born again believers in Jesus Christ, we get caught up to meet Jesus in the air, and then we go for 7 years to be in heaven. So 726 in Greek, Strong's Concordance, that is harpazo. So yesterday, well, let's listen to the song. I was like, wow, I'll fly away. Let's listen to the song.
I had a dream that someday I would just fly, fly away. And I always knew I couldn't stay. So I had a dream that I just fly away. I've been on my own for a minute. Is it only me out here? Searching for the place to begin it. Is it me? Is it you? Is it fear? Standing on the line I was given. People stare and ask me why I'm here. No one seems to think that I fit in. But I don't wanna be like them. No, cause I don't wanna be like them. Cause I know that I had a dream that someday I would just fly, fly away. I always knew I couldn't stay. So I had a dream that I'd just fly away, away.
I'll fly away. 726 views. Yeah, 726.
This powerful $99 drone is now available.
Yesterday, so this is a picture of a book by my uncle, Judge Thomas Dillon. I didn't even know that he had written a book. I hadn't seen him in like 30-something years. And he just passed away, 91 years old. And it turns out he was a born-again Christian. And I didn't know it. Nobody told me. Nobody told me. I hadn't seen him like in 35 years. My uncle, my cousin Tommy, his oldest, had really bad cerebral palsy. He was basically nonverbal. I loved him. I loved him. And it turned out that when he got the ability to communicate through a computer, he was a Christian. And he wrote all these beautiful poems and writings and stuff about Jesus Christ. He could communicate like with a grunting kind of thing that you knew yes or no. And I guess he must have died when he was about in his mid-30s or something. So I already knew that he's up in heaven. But Uncle Tom, 91 years old. So like on March 16th of 2017, I had a dream about the rapture. That's the whole reason my channel was started. And here, Becca Shea had a dream about flying away. She's not saying it's a rapture dream, but I'm assuming it is. Anyway, we don't know the day and hour, but it is kind of strange to me that this was March 16th, 2017, 3/16/2017, and her video length was, I think it was 3/18, 3/18, 3/17, but Colossians 3:16-17, I don't know what 18 is. I probably should look that up. Maybe y'all could look that up. Anyway, Colossians 3:17 is my channel verse. And she, it says in verse 16, it talks about singing in psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, like singing in tongues. And then 17, it's like, do whatever you say or do, do as a representative of Jesus Christ. So it turns out that I didn't go to the funeral because I asked the Lord and he told me not to go. The reason why was the funeral happened to be on the same day as my father-in-law's funeral was 9 years ago. And that did not go well. I was, my husband, you know, he had remarried by that point and had another child. And so I had to sit in the back of the church. I was not included in the family. I was written out of the obituary. My children were basically assigned to another woman because it just said my husband's name, his new wife's name, and his four children's name. I was not even mentioned, even though I had been married to him for 26 years before he divorced me. Anyway, I hadn't seen Uncle Tom in years, and it turns out, oh, sorry, y'all. So it turns out he wrote this book in 2018. So 3/16/2017 plus 2017 days equals September 23rd, 2022, which is the anniversary of the Revelation 12 sign. Today is the 1 year birthday of my grandson. September 23rd is the 1 year birthday of my granddaughter. And September 20th is the 5 year anniversary of when God told me that I was healed of my PTSD. Praise the Lord. And I stayed up and I was awake for 42 hours. I was so excited to be healed in Jesus' name. Thank you. I had sought and sought and asked the Lord to heal me, and he did. Praise the Lord. Thank you, God. So that was September 20th of 2017. And then I had a rapture dream on the morning of September 23rd, 2017, which a lot of people, that was Feast of Trumpets. That was the Revelation 12 sign day. And in that dream, I was carrying up a baby girl in the rapture and went up to heaven. It's a long dream. So I had a dream, that was my first rapture dream that actually had arrived in heaven. That was on September 23rd of 2017. And then the next day, I had a dream about being in a wedding dress again, which is what my first dream was about. And then the next day, I had another dream about the wedding in heaven. So that's all on my YouTube channel, you know. And a lot of people are like, oh, you know, you shouldn't be dreaming. You should just be reading the Word. Well, believe me, I agree. We should be reading the Word. We got to know the Word. So, Uncle Tom, this book, The Road to Glory, that he wrote in 2018, this is the chat. I was just so amazed because I read in the obituary that he had written a book. And then I went to Amazon and it was available on Amazon. So I ordered it. I read it. It was fantastic. These are the chapters. The Serpent in the Way. Clothed for the Trip. The Wrong Way on the Right Road. The Way Through the Flood. The Two Roads. Highway Robbers. A Feast to Remember. Into the War Zone. Into the Land of Giants. Rest for the Traveler. And The Road to Glory. And let me see. I'm pretty sure. Hang on a second. Sorry, I'm just sort of filming this as I go. But I actually read it on Kindle before I received the book. But this is on page 2. The beautiful promise that we have that the Lord Jesus Christ has prepared a place for his people. He said, "In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, you may be also." John 14:2-3. That is our promise. And then he goes and describes the heavenly home and the mansions and all that. He's got a lot of scriptures in here. And I'm just like, wow, this is absolutely amazing. And then he goes into the penalty for disobedience. The soul that sinneth, it shall die. And so it's just a really, I'm just so excited. It's a really fantastic book. And let me see, I think at the end, I'm just going by my memory of what, when I read it on, oh yeah, look. Okay, so then this is the last chapter, The Road to Glory, right there. And look, there it is, the Harpazo scriptures in my uncle's book. I'm like, oh my goodness, I've got a family member that's going to be up there in heaven. And he's one of the first that's going to be rising first from the dead. Okay, he says, here's the promise of the believer's future and the glory of God. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, so that we meet, caught up is 7:26. So we meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. 1 Thessalonians 4:16. Is that not just amazing? And then he gives the gospel and how to be saved, and he gives his testimony of how he got saved. He talks all about our glorified bodies. And the very last part of the book says, the door to the road of light and life still has room to enter. Some of the words in the last chapter of the scriptures are words of invitation. And the Spirit and the bride say, "Come, and let him that heareth come, and let him that is athirst come, and whosoever will, let him take of the water of life freely." Revelation 22:17. Praise the Lord. And this is the back of the book. I just really was encouraged by reading it. If anybody wants to order it on Amazon, I'll put in the link to the book. But I'm like, wow, praise the Lord. I'm just so excited. And yesterday when I was going to, oh, we're about to see 11:11. Usually when I say I see 11:11, it's just like it suddenly shows up, 11:11. But anyway, yesterday I was like praising the Lord. I'm driving And I had sent a sympathy card to my aunt. They were married for 70 years. 70 years. His testimony of how he got born again was that he'd been a believer. Actually, he had gotten a degree in theology. He was a juvenile court judge here in Fulton County, where all that stuff went on in Fulton County. He was a juvenile court judge. He was a preacher, a pastor for 3 churches. I didn't know all this stuff. My parents didn't talk about him that much, even though, we were close growing up and everything, but I hadn't seen him in a long time. But anyway, they were married for 70 years, and, that's just a beautiful thing, a covenant marriage. And let's see. So his testimony was that he had always had anger, seething anger in his heart. And so he got on the floor on his face and he cried out to the Lord one day and asked for God to take away this anger that was always with him. And he said it just released, and that he received the Holy Spirit and that he got born again. And I think he must have been he doesn't give the actual date of it, but it must have been like in his 80s is what I'm thinking, because of him saying that that is what drove him to write this book in 2018. And to think that God is telling me about the rapture in 2017, he's telling Uncle Tom about it in 2017, 2018. Like amazing. Absolutely amazing. So anyway, I was going to go mail the card. And when I got in my car, the car clock, which is the wrong time, was 7:11. 7:11, let's go to heaven. But also 1 Corinthians 7, 10 and 11, which I use all the time. If a woman does depart, she is to remain unmarried or be reconciled to her husband, and a husband must not divorce his wife. I've always got to talk about it because so few people do talk about it, but divorce and remarriage is adultery, period. It is. As long as your husband or your wife is alive, you are still married. I probably should do a video about seeing some people get put in comments about how God has shown them that they've either had a dream that they were going to hell because of divorce and remarriage, or God has spoken to them, and they'll put in comments. I've been putting comments in about this for 5 years, and they'll put in comments saying, hey, you're right, but they put it in these other videos. So maybe I should do a thing and just show you that they're the people that are learning this, the truth, and they want to be right with God. Anyway, as I'm driving, and I'm praising the Lord after I dropped off post office her sympathy card, which I did put in a couple of gospel tracks because that's what I got to do, right? As I'm driving, I'm praising the Lord, and I'm like, God, I know that you're coming soon. I don't know if you're going to come on Feast of Trumpets. I just know that you're coming soon. And if it's after Feast of Trumpets, that's fine too, because we're everyday rapture watchers. And even that, if he comes, like I said, the 2017 days from the first rapture dream is on September 23rd. And then 2022 days from the first rapture dream is September 28th. And on Renewed Moon, the new moon is expected to be seen over Israel on the night of September 27th. So they may be celebrating Feast of Trumpets a day early, which then don't be discouraged if we are still here because it's a day or two behind what the world thinks is Feast of Trumpets, okay? I don't know if he's going to come on Feast of Trumpets. I hope so, but I don't know. It doesn't matter to me. Every day is a day he could come. Anyway, I'm praising the Lord, and then I come up to a light, and there's a pickup truck, a white pickup truck in front of me, and I look down, and the car tag is BCE. I think that's right. No, BRE7026. So there's the 726, and then I'm thinking BRE, Believers Rapture Escaping, or Beloved Rapture Escape. you know, whatever. You can come up with your own thing. But I'm just like, it made me cry, y'all. It made me cry to think that God knows exactly where we are. Each person, he knows where we are, when we're going to be there. And I know it sounds so silly to think that looking at a car tag would make you cry. But to think that God saved any of us, right? And that we're alive for such a time as this. And so then I'm driving over to leave a card at my son and daughter-in-law's house for the baby's birthday. And when I pull up to their neighborhood, there is a Ragsdale truck. And Ragsdale is, the Ragsdale family is my grandmother's family. And the number on it was 113. And I had a dream about going through a war field and looking for something in the war field, like back and forth through the war field. And of course, Uncle Tom has a chapter about the war field. And when I finally found what I was looking for, it was a silver powder shell, a silver powder compact, like an antique powder compact with inside of it. It was in the shape of a shell, like I found the pearl of great price. It was in the shape of a shell, and when I opened it up, it was engraved with Nancy Overton, 1/13/1948. Now, 1/13 would be Nisan 13, the day before Passover. 1948, Israel's birthday. Nancy means grace. The age of grace is going to be over with the rapture, right? And then comes the tribulation. Nancy Overton was a real woman. Not associated with 1/13/1948, as far as I can tell, but she was a real woman. She sang in the quartets, and she sang the song, Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream, make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Okay, that song. She also sang a song called The Wedding. How about that? I don't know. Maybe she was a born-again Christian, too. I don't know. Anyway, so 1/13/1948. I don't remember other things associated. I did a video about 1/13. But also, 1/13 is 11/3, which is my birthday. And I'm hoping we're not going to be here on November 3rd, but, you know, if we are, we are. What can I say? I think my proverb 11:3 is something about honesty. Honesty guides godly people. Something like that. I'll put it in the description box. I can't remember what it is off the top of my head. I was like, you know, because I know my grandmother was a born-again Christian. I know my grandmother is up in heaven, too. This uncle was the son-in-law to my grandmother, okay? To Aunt Frances, her daughter, okay? So then, as I'm leaving there, I look down and my car clock says 8:26. You know, 7:26 are pods. I was like, what is 8:26? And for those who don't use Strong's Concordance, let me just show you. This is how it works. This is an app called Bible Hub. Okay? And so you just click on extra resources. So this is a Greek concordance. And then you put in 8:26. And push Greek. Come on. Okay. And then it comes up to shine forth. Now, of course, I wasn't looking it up at the time of I'm driving, but the funny thing was when I saw the car clock was 8:26, the car tag, my car clock, which is not the right time, the car tag next to me said 8:26, and the car tag in front of it was 22:22. Now, 22 is my favorite God number, and I know that 22:22 means life. And Joseph Aquaviva, 2222. I do recommend his channel because he looks into all of the numbers regarding Obama. And for those of us who, or for those who know my channel, I've had two dreams about Obama, and I've also heard from the Lord. He is definitely the Antichrist. Okay, so 826, to shine forth. I flash, gleam, shine forth, appear white, bright, but perhaps I see clearly, discern. And that is what we need. We need discernment. And then all you do is you just go down and you look for the verse. And it's in 2 Corinthians 4:4. So that they might not see. Now, see, there's a big difference right there. So they might not see the light. And then KJV says, of God should shine onto them. And then the interlinear, you know, you can just click on the interlinear. And it will show you all the numbers for the whole sentence, okay? But what I usually do when God, and I haven't done it yet today, but usually when God shows me a number like that, then I just go ahead and read the whole chapter. So I'll just be reading 2 Corinthians chapter 4. And that's how I can do a Bible study based on seeing a number. To beam forth. Illumination of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the unique image of God. Yeah, I mean, this is the way it works for me. And then the car tag in front of me was 33, which I also have memorized, but I will show you 33. Just go down here. 33. Oh, it must be in the Hebrew. Oh, weird. Huh. Oh, wait, it's not showing me 33. Why is it not showing me 33? I don't know. Okay, so the app's not working right. I don't know. Hold on. Yeah, so this is another way to do it. You just Google Strong's 33, which I know what it means. And then you click on that. And it means to come. And it's used twice. And there you go down. Oh, my hand's starting to shake. I'm holding that heavy phone for quite a while. And it's not giving me the scripture context. I don't know. What's wrong? Anyway. Oh, well, there it is. To come, come now. Okay, so that's just a quick explanation of how to use Strong's Concordance. And I hope that you're having a blessed day. And I also recommend this book, God Speaks and How to Hear Him 101 Different Ways. I've shown this before, but if you're new to my channel, you wouldn't know about this. But God definitely speaks to his sheep. And I'll just show you the table of contents. These are 101 different ways. And look right there. He speaks in through numbers, through Strong's Concordance definitions. He speaks through different versions of the Bible. Look at the table of contents and see what you think. He speaks through where our eyes glance. He speaks through what we sing. And if you haven't watched my video with the new song that I received on September 3rd, please do. I know it's a really heavy song, but it is the gospel. And it ends with our blessed hope. He speaks through recurring songs. He speaks through the gift of exhortation, service, hospitality, giving, ruling, mercy, helps, governments. He speaks through soul dreams. He speaks through children and gifts. Children's words. the seniors. He spoke through my Uncle Tom. The missionaries. He speaks through appointed gifts, apostles, prophets. You know, it's prophesying when you receive a song. And I have prophesied before. A long prophecy was given to me on June 5th. He speaks through evangelists. And that was what this song was. This song was an evangelism song. He speaks through teachers and the gift of teaching. Yeah, just look at this. He speaks through the still small voice. You know, if you know his still small voice, that's what I do, is I usually try to wake up in the morning and start to tune into his voice and say, you know, Father, what is it that you would have me do today? Because he says, only those who obey the will of my Father will enter heaven. And many will say, Lord, Lord, we did all these things. We cast out demons in your name. We prophesied in your name. And he says, go away. I never knew you. You who continued in lawlessness and iniquity. You know, we live holy because we have been saved. He speaks through the inner audible voice. He speaks through visions, pictures. He speaks through Holy Spirit dreams, and dreams have a purpose. Gifts of the Spirit, a word of knowledge, a gift of faith, gifts of healing, working of miracles, prophecy, discerning of spirits, tongues, the interpretation of tongues. He speaks through numbers on clocks. He speaks when we wait for confirmation. Confirmation is important. I mean, this is what he does. He speaks through when we ponder on his words as we're studying the word. He speaks when we abide in Jesus. He speaks when we let him lead. He speaks when we yield. He speaks when we're at rest. He speaks when we pause. He speaks when we follow our conscience. He speaks when we do not strive. When we pray, when we worship, when we make holy choices. When we seek counsel, he speaks when we fast. He speaks through puzzling together accumulated knowledge. That's pretty funny, as we puzzle together as to when Jesus is coming. He speaks through balancing knowledge with quickening. And then pursuing the supernatural. Discerning of counterfeit spirits. That's what we need to be able to do. Rebuking enemy thoughts. Discerning the gifted vessel. What does that say right there? Oh, giant and flesh list. Yeah, you know, I actually don't think I've read this last part, these last chapters of this Bible. But anyway, I do recommend this Bible. I have about 20 books on hearing God's voice. Oh, there it is, though. It does say, know the Bible. Does it agree with the Bible? Know the Holy Spirit. Identify the flesh. The sins of the flesh will kill you. And take you to hell one day. No hypocrite, adulterer, or fornicator will make it to the pearly gates. That's just the song that I heard on September 3rd. And the rest of the song he gave to me later. I mean, I recorded that. And then I recorded the rest of it like a minute or two later. So... And there's the car tag. I know the picture was really, it was a very dirty car tag, so it's kind of hard to see. But there it is. I'm just praying to the Lord, and then I look up, and that's the car tag in front of me, BRE7026. And there is Ragsdale Heating, Air, and Plumbing, and there's the 113. Oh, look at that, in the car tag, it says 627, and 627, I see that a lot too. I think it has something to do with gathering. I'm just going to add, these are a couple of pictures I had taken. I got this from Joseph Acquaviva, that 1111, which a lot of us see, is the gematria for Luke 21:28, KJV. And when these things begin to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. How about that? That's a great 11:11. And here's another one. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. That is 11:11 in gematria also. So God definitely speaks in numbers, uses numbers. God is amazing about everything. No God, no peace. That's K-N-O-W. No Jesus, no peace. N-O, no Jesus. Without Jesus, you have no peace. And if you hear people saying, peace, peace, when there is no peace, run from those people. You know, Elijah was one of 900, and I think there were 950 false prophets, and Elijah was the only true prophet. So, hope something here blessed you. Read your Bible. Read your Bible. Oops, I did want to add 627 that was on that Ragsdale truck means a collection. It's a collection, a gathering. And in Greek, it means a speech in defense, apologia, a speech in defense, a verbal defense, particularly in law court. Properly, a well-reasoned reply, a thought-out response to adequately address the issue that is raised. And let's see, defense, vindication. And then, you know, this is how you can do a Bible study. And I like to just read the chapters so I get the full, I mean, I have plenty of time, but so I get the full thing. 2 Corinthians 7:11. See, I do know 1 Corinthians 7:10 and 11, I read to you about divorce or marriage. And then 2 Corinthians 7:10 and 11, very, very important. For godly sorrow worketh repentance. Whoops, goodness, hang on, I clicked the wrong thing. For godly sorrow worketh repentance to salvation, not to be repented of. But the sorrow of the world worketh death. For behold, this selfsame thing, that ye sorrowed after a godly sort, what carefulness it wrought in you, yes, what clearing of yourselves, yes, what indignation, yes, what fear, yes, what vehement desire, yes, what zeal, yes, what revenge, in all things ye have approved yourselves to be clear in the matter. That's what repentance is to be completely done. Let me see if I can read in a different translation so it might be more clear. And I really do hope that this video has turned out okay, because normally I'd record a video with my phone turned sideways instead of straight up and down, but the way the video started out with that song, I figured I couldn't change it over. But anyway, this is 2 Corinthians 7:10-11. For the kind of sorrow God wants us to experience leads us away from sin and results in salvation. There is no regret for that kind of sorrow, but worldly sorrow, which lacks repentance, results in spiritual death. Just see what godly sorrow produced in you. Such earnestness, such concern to clear yourselves, such indignation, such alarm, such longing to see me, and we can say longing to see Jesus, such zeal, and such a readiness to punish wrong. You showed that you have done everything necessary to make things right. And this is being written to the church because they had removed the immoral brother in 1 Corinthians chapter 5 who was claiming to be a believer, but he was living in sin. So that's what we're supposed to do. When we truly belong to the Lord, true repentance is that we are going to turn from the sin and have godly sorrow. Let's see it in another translation. And here it is in the New King James. That last one was NLT. For godly sorrow produces repentance leading to salvation, not to be regretted, but the sorrow of the world produces death. You know, they say, I'm sorry, but they never turn. For observe this very thing, that you sorrowed in a godly manner, what diligence it produced in you, what clearing of yourselves, what indignation, what fear, that be fear of the Lord, what vehement desire, what zeal, what vindication, and all vindication, I think, was the 627. In all things you approved yourselves to be clear in this matter. You know, it also says that our repentance should produce works in keeping with repentance. So, anyway, I hope that's blessed you. God bless you, Maranatha. I'm looking for Jesus every single day. And let's just hope that we're up in those clouds very soon. Maranatha, Maranatha, God bless y'all.